Welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to look at 5 possible explanations for what happened in the opening match of Night 2 of WrestleMania 37. In the match between Randy Orton and The Fiend, we are going to touch up on if Alexa Bliss controls The Fiend. The Fiend saw someone else in Alexa Bliss at WrestleMania 37. And if WWE is building Alexa Bliss versus The Fiend after WrestleMania 37. Stick around until the end. Before we get into it, be sure to drop a like and subscribe. After an adrenaline-filled night 1 of WrestleMania 37, the second night of the PPV kicked off with the match between The Fiend and Randy Orton. The WWE Universe laid in wait to see how this match would unravel. Many believed that The Fiend would squash Randy Orton at WrestleMania, but to everyone's surprise, the Apex Predator hit The Fiend with an RKO for the win. What perplexed every other member of the WWE Universe was the bizarre ending to the match. Just when The Fiend had Orton set up for Sister Abigail, Alexa Bliss emerged out of the box that was ringside to grab The Fiend's attention. The reason why The Fiend was distracted by Bliss is unclear, and we may get a clearer picture of tomorrow night's WWE Raw, but here are 5 possible explanations for what happened in the opening match of Night 2 of WrestleMania 37. Number 5, Alexa Bliss controls The Fiend at WrestleMania 37. Ever since The Fiend was burnt by Randy Orton at TLC in December, Alexa Bliss has been the one to direct the storyline that leads to his match against Orton at WrestleMania. Bliss was the one who kept warning Orton that The Fiend would eventually return and that Orton would have to pay for what he did to him at TLC. During The Fiend's absence, Alexa Bliss has shown mystical powers in the form of shooting fireballs and controlling ringside equipment. During her match against the Viper at WWE Fastlane, Alexa Bliss even orchestrated The Fiend's return, which saw him rise from under the ring. It looked like Alexa Bliss was the one who was always in control of The Fiend, and it shouldn't come as a surprise if she is revealed as the one who controls the actions of The Fiend in the coming WWE shows. Number 4, The Fiend saw someone else in Alexa Bliss at WrestleMania 37. When The Fiend saw Alexa Bliss emerge out of the box that was at ringside at WrestleMania 37, it looked like he was in a trance and couldn't take his eyes off her. To the fans, it looked like she had cast a spell on him that distracted him to fall prey to the Viper. What we as fans and viewers saw was Alexa Bliss covered in a black liquid that continued oozing out of her head. But nobody but The Fiend knows what he saw at WrestleMania 37. Maybe Bliss reminded The Fiend of someone Bray Wyatt knew, and it was Wyatt who cost The Fiend the match. An explanation of what The Fiend saw in Bliss could be Sister Abigail. Since his debut, Bray Wyatt has spoken of Sister Abigail on many occasions. In his earlier promos, Wyatt has mentioned that he did what he did because of her, and she was the reason he was the person he was. It wouldn't be too far-fetched for many WWE fans to believe that The Fiend actually saw Sister Abigail when the rest of the world only saw Alexa Bliss. Number 3, Alexa Bliss turned on The Fiend at WrestleMania 37. A little less than a year ago, Alexa Bliss was approached by The Fiend when she was all alone in the ring on an episode of WWE SmackDown. Since then, Bliss has used Sister Abigail as her finisher and has turned on people she considered near and dear. Nobody really knows what happened between The Fiend and Alexa Bliss, but she hasn't been the same ever since. Maybe this is a way of Little Miss Bliss retaliating to what The Fiend did to her. It could be possible that she is done siding with The Fiend, and the black liquid oozing out of her symbolizes the same. Bliss and The Fiend's association has lasted for almost a year and they have created many compelling storylines together. No fan likes to see the end of an entertaining alliance, but who knows, maybe WWE has greater things in store for both characters if they have decided to part ways. Number 2, building Alexa Bliss versus The Fiend after WrestleMania 37. It could be possible that WWE is moving towards an intergender match between The Fiend and Alexa Bliss after WrestleMania. There could be 2 ways to go about this match. The Fiend could be battling Alexa Bliss, someone who controls him, to get away from her clutches. If The Fiend is successful in defeating Bliss, it could mean that we see him go away and bring back Bray Wyatt. Another way this match between the two WWE superstars could go down is Alexa Bliss fighting for her right to break free from The Fiend. We aren't sure whether Bliss wanted to align with The Fiend in the first place. It looked like she was overcome by The Fiend, that leads to her complete change in character. The match between these two doesn't need to involve hellacious beatdowns. It could be a cinematic masterclass with great storytelling. The Fiend and Bliss are great characters and will surely deliver something memorable if this is to happen in the near future. Number 1. A new pain phase for Alexa Bliss. Like how the Fiend Bray Wyatt's gloves red hurt and heal, Alexa Bliss's has play and pain. In the past few weeks, we have seen Alexa Bliss host her own show called Alexa's Playground. The set to the playhouse is decked with swings and other toys that children play with. Until WrestleMania, we have seen Bliss in a happy-go-lucky role, making her way to the ring dancing all around. Maybe WrestleMania kicks off Bliss's painful phase that in some way affects The Fiend. The Fiend and Alexa Bliss's alliance is one of the better parts of every episode of WWE Raw. Breaking them up would disappoint many fans and force them to question the decision. However, adding a new leaf to their relationship and gripping fans with good storytelling will only enhance both characters for a longer time. Currently, there is no clear explanation as to why The Fiend was distracted by Alexa Bliss at WrestleMania. We will have to wait for tomorrow night's WWE Raw to watch this story unravel. Until then, if you have any theories in mind, we would be happy to hear them in the comments section below.